mtoto anaweza kuwa na miba kwa mguu. This is what I call responsibility. Mtoto anaweza kuwa miba kwa mguu, lakini ukitaka kutoa hiyo miba atakataa, atalia sana. In fact hata atataka kuchapa baba yake kwa sababu hiyo miba iko kwa mguu. Hata akiwa na something nini, kama silaha anaweza chapa baba. But unaweza acha mtoto wako awe na hiyo nini makosa? No, utashika mtoto hata kama analia. Nashika mtoto, unatoa hiyo nini miba. Analia, anatoa miba kabisa, alafu unaweka dawa, analia akienda. That is Gen C for me, or Generation C. They can cry, but we will lazima tutoe hiyo miba ndio hiyo watoto wakule. Kwani watakula nini? So nyinyi muendelee, watoto wetu sisi hatuchapi nyinyi, na polisi msichape sana. Tunatoa miba kidogo kidogo tu, alafu tutakula kesho, si ndio? I voted yes, and many people were surprised or something like that. Let me say this. The reason, there are many things that of course informs everybody, and I took my decision in that direction as representing the people of Pokot South. And when I look at it as a leader, as much as there are issues which were corrected in finance bill, I think for me, what I say, the biggest problem which I've seen in the last two financial years in terms of finance bill is that this government has made finance bill or finance discussion or government discussion so people centric, so people involving. That is why everybody is involved. So for me, that is positive. I'm not saying even if those small, what do you call those Gen Z, I know, are not in Pokot. I mean, these people are in towns and so on and so forth. That is a town terminology. In Pokot, we don't know what we're calling them. But I think that is point number one, that Kenyans are more involved. So I don't see any problem, and I don't see any negativity. In fact, this is a time when people know something called finance bill. I don't think if Kenyans have known or have heard anything called finance bill for many years, I think since independence. So this is a positive thing that I'm seeing myself. Kenyans are participating. That's number one. Number two, I voted for responsibility. You know, we as leaders, we must stand by two things as leaders. Number one, responsibility, which is what? Which is that we must pay our bills as people of Kenya. That is number one. We are like parents. Of course, we are leaders as parents. So you cannot allow your house is going without food. No, you must find food for this house. Who is finding food for Kenya? It's us as leaders. So that's responsibility. And then number two, we're also tampering that responsibility with the punitive tax. You know, we cannot just say pass anything just because of anything. If there are punitive tax, we tell the government and say, hey, sorry, this is a punitive, which we were able to do. And government had responded by removing those, what you call punitive taxes. So when you remove punitive taxes, and you tamper with the responsibility, then you have no option. The only option is let's go forward so that we can be able to help our country. In terms of responsibility, of course, as Honorable Marian said, if you don't pass that finance bill to get money to develop a place and get cheaper power, Kenyans are now crying for cheaper power. So where do we get cheaper power? We get cheaper power by developing GDC. So when we develop GDC, you know why it's cheap? Because it's sustainable power. So when you get sustainable power, we get two things as a people of Kenya. We get cheaper power because it is our own resource, it's natural resource. This is what God put here for us. So we get cheap power by getting this natural resource. Number two, we get what you call stable power, not fluctuating power. Right? We get stable power. It has been found by research that geothermal energy is like energy produced by nuclear power. Nuclear power and this one are very close. If you see nuclear power, the electricity which is produced is stable throughout. Even also this one for geothermal is stable. So if we don't find resources to be able to develop this, so how shall we make our power cheap going forward? That will be responsibility, and that is why some of us, using our Article 95 in terms of representation, we took the responsibility we have taken, and that is how we are going to move our country forward. And then as she says, to give Kenyans also opportunity to open the bill. So, you know, if the bill does not go to start reading, how will you know what happens in clause 1, clause 2, clause 3, clause 4, and clause 5? But as I conclude, we are driven by responsibility. Personally, I was driven by responsibility as I'm a Kenyan. We must feed our country. You know, let me tell you as I conclude, simply.
And my comment why I voted on the 2024 finance bill, yes, I voted because we want the government to run. What I saw there that pleased me, we have JCC teachers. These teachers have been complaining, they have been demonstrating that they need to be absorbed. What I've seen in that bill that made me vote yes, our JCC teachers are going to be absorbed, and even 20,000 more will be absorbed as interns, and in future they'll also be absorbed. That's what made me vote. Number two, we have been supplying sanitary pads as 47 women representatives. These pads are gotten from China. We went as 47, we talked to the president, and he said that those sanitary pads, the government will supply free of charge, and they will be produced in every county. Now, if an industry, a light industry is constructed in every county, this one shows that the locals, Gen Z, will be able to work in those small industries in their counties, and they will put money in their pockets. Another thing that made me vote, even here Pokot, instead of the girls using cowdanga and mud, they will be able, the women rep will be able to set up an industry here which will employ the locals of this county. And the same to me in my county, Vihiga. So that's why I voted for that bill. Another thing that made me really vote for that bill, when there was a public outcry about bread, and I remember telling my people in my county that the head of state will not be able to increase bread. Bread is a necessity for every homestead, and it was removed. That tax was removed. So I had to vote for that that bill. And if somebody will go around like I gather somebody's rounding funerals telling people Adagala voted, rejected Adagala voted, yes, I want to tell that person he's the enemy of progress. We want people to live dignified life. We want medicines in our hospitals. We want our teachers paid. We want our civil servants paid. We want KDF, the police, to get their salaries. And even him, he keeps on talking of earning 1.5 million. Where will the government get that 1.5 million to pay him? So these people rounding funerals, telling people this is a punitive bill, I want to tell our people, this bill, we are going to be alert as your representatives. Once money has been collected, we want to ask the president of this republic, William Samoei Ruto, to ensure money is put in the right place, and the corrupt officers, those ones we have to watch, and corruption, they should be take, they should take a necessary action to ensure such fellows are arrested and they are put in, and they have also to return people's tax. So we are not going to condone corruption. That one, as your representatives, we are ready, and we are standing here as MPs. We are saying we are very stern. And that's why even we have come to check the figures of this institution. And we have seen they are doing a good job.
Mimi ni mmoja ya wale heroes ama shujaa ambao walipiga kura ya ndio kwa ile mswada wa fedha kule bungeni jana. Na tulifanya hivyo si kwa sababu hati hatupendi wa Kenya. Lakini kwanza kabisa ni lazima tukubali kwamba ule mswada ama ile bill iliyokuja kutoka executive ikaja bunge ni kweli ilikuwa na utata, ilikuwa na vipengele ambavyo vilikuwa vina shida kidogo. Lakini baada ya public participation kwa ile kamati ya bunge, tuliona kwamba vile vipengele vilivyokuwa na utata vyote vinaweza kushughulikiwa na vikaweza kuondolewa. Na ile ripoti iliyo songwa ndani ya bunge ile siku ya Jumatano ilikuwa imeshughulikia all the concerns ambazo hawa vijana ambao wamekuwa katika streets wa protest zilikuwa zimeweza kuondolewa. Kwa hivyo mimi kama mtu ambaye napenda maendeleo na najua nchi haiwezi kuendelea bila ushuru, niliona kuangusha ile mswada katika ile stage tutakuwa tumefanya Kenyans a lot of injustice. Na kama vile wenzangu wamesema hapa, ile ilikuwa tu ni second reading. Bado sasa tunaingia katika third reading ambapo kama bado kuna vipengele katika ule mswada ambao bado vina shida, sisi kama wabunge tuna nafasi ya kuweza kuvichambua mmoja kimoja baada ya kingine kuhakikisha kwamba tunapatia Wakenya finance bill ile ambayo itaweza kufungua uchumi wetu. Kwa hivyo mimi ni kuambia tu Wakenya ama wale vijana ambao wamekuwa wakifanya maandamano ni kwamba ile information ambayo wanapewa especially na civil society, wale ni watu ambao wanapotosha wananchi kuhusu hii mambo ya mswada. Mimi nimejaribu kuhoji kadha na kilo naongea naye ni kama ambaye hajui ni kwa nini anafanya maandamano. Maana ukimuuliza ni kwa nini anaandamana anasema ni kwa vile serikali imeongeza ushuru. Na ukimuuliza ni ushuru gani umeongezwa hawezi kukujibu hilo swali. Kwa hivyo ni kama ambaye ni kasumba ambayo wameweza kupewa. Na mimi nawaambia watulize boli kidogo kwa sababu nafikiri baada ya third reading tutapatia wananchi financial bill ambayo mimi kwa upande wangu najua itaweza kabisa kusaidia hii Kenya especially katika mambo ya kuchumi. Na ni lazima pia tusaidie rais. Saizi sisi tunaongea kwa tunataka Kenya endelee. Sisi tukienda mashinani wananchi wanatuliza mambo ya maendeleo, mambo ya barabara, mambo ya mashule zetu, mambo ya mahospitali. Hizi zote mheshimiwa rais hawezi kuzifanya kama hakuna bila hataweza kukusanya ushuru. Kwa hivyo mimi naomba tupatie nafasi hii serikali iweze kufanya zile ahadi ambazo iliweza kuahidi wananchi.
I'm happy to be here today after yesterday's vote in parliament. Remember yesterday we were voting on the second reading of the finance bill as to whether it goes to the third reading or not. And Gen Z or Generation Z were up in arms and they are telling us, why did you vote yes? One is because we need to give an opportunity to the bill to be dissected, because now we go to the third reading where we look at clause by clause by clause, and those clauses that Generation Z are feeling like or generally Kenyans are feeling like are not punitive, we will have an opportunity now to reject and modify, and those clauses that are good, we have an opportunity to allow them to go. Why is this finance bill very important? We've come here today. And looking at the installation that we have come here today, I'm looking at a very big water tank. That is a water tank I've never seen anywhere in this country. I've looked at the pipeline, 4 million liters of water. I've looked at the pipeline from Lake Baringo up to these hills here in Paka. And that is a water pipeline, not one line. There are about 4 lines of water. And this drilling requires about 3,600 cubic meters of water on a, to be able to do that particular drilling. I have looked at the drilling rigs. The drilling rig is about 3 million shillings. I have looked at the materials that are required, the heads that are required. One head is about 4 million shillings, and you will be able to use more than one head to be able to drill. I have looked at the capacity that GTC are saying this geothermal power can give us. It can give us up to 10,000 megawatts. We have been experiencing power blackouts in this country, and we want to say that we need to finance such operations in this country so that we can be power independent, one, and two, our cost of power comes down. Because right now when we use thermal, the ones that we use fuel, it is more expensive, and therefore cost of production in this country, cost of industrialization, which then affects cost of getting employment for this, the very youth who are in the streets yesterday, who are looking for employment. So it's a whole ripple effect. And that's why we're saying we must pass a finance bill that will finance us, that will be able to finance and fund these operations. And when we fund these operations, then we know that we become an independent country. We are able to bring production here. And in fact, we are telling GDC, you should be able to acquire more land here so that industries can come and set up here and are able to buy power at less than 3 US cents per kilowatt hour, and therefore become very productive. We want the Generation Z and all everybody else to come and work here so that they create employment, because their cry is that there is no employment. Where is this tax going to? And therefore we are saying this tax that we are asking for is not to be wasted, but it is actually to do resources. And we want to encourage and ask the government that any tax that is collected, Mr. President, make sure that tax is used for proper use. And if there is any pilferage, Mr. President, take responsibility for that pilgrimage and make sure that you fire whoever it is, you take action on it so that a Kenyan feels the need to actually collect that tax. Thank you.